ISUPK.
They try to tell me I can't win, all because of the skin I'm in. But then I look in the mirror again, and then we realize we better than them, we better than them.
They divided and they conquered my kin, but separated by the pigmentation of our skin. It's just that white supremacy agenda again. They want your mind in gold, cutting sugar cane, turning cotton gins. We left the plantation, then they pushed us into tenements. Police patrolling, hunting all my people like we're venison. The government's the criminals, they the real terrorists. Moving more coke than a Cuban watching pelicans. Selling all the dope, trying to kill us with the medicine. You a slave if you think that we're American. America was great before the pilgrims had a settlement. Trump gets in office, blacks uniting with the Mexicans. Black, Hispanic, Haitians, Jamaicans, we all relatives.
Good afternoon, Port of Spain. We are the ISUPK out of 1 West, 125th Street, Highland, New York, under commanding General Yohana. We teach that the so-called black man, so-called Hispanic man, so-called Native Indian man, that we are all one family. We are all from the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. Today, black man, Hispanic man, Native Indian man, today our communities are lawless. Today our communities are oppressed. Today our communities are under disaster, and our communities are under distress. Because why? Because there are no laws in our community. Our communities are destroyed because of the Christian church and the Muslim mosque. The Christian church say the laws of God are done away with. The Christian church say that we are saved by grace and we no longer have to keep the laws of God. Your Christian church is lying to you.
That's right.
Your Christian church and your pastor are liars.
That's right.
They teach you to sin against the Most High.
That's right.
The laws of God are not done away with. The laws of God are still in existence. And we're gonna show it right here in the Bible that your Christian pastor is lying to you. For the Spain, we have seen so much lies and so much deception that the Christian church has been preaching to us. This is why the black community is destroyed. This is why the Hispanic community is destroyed. This is why the Native Indian community is destroyed. It's because Christianity has destroyed our communities. When the Christian church tell you that the laws of God are done away with, when the Muslim mosque do not teach the laws of God, they destroy our people. That is why black on black crime is at a high. That is why we sell drugs to each other. That is why we murder each other, because there's no laws governing us. It's because the so-called Christian church has destroyed us. This is why we are in so much distress.
Go ahead, read.
Book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 17. Think not that I'm come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
Think not that I have come to destroy the law and the prophets. Think not that he have come to destroy the law and the prophets. Because the laws of God have been set here for a reason. The laws of God have been here. This is why, black man, Hispanic man, Native Indian man, we are destroyed. This is why we as a people have to come here. This is why we have to come and teach our brothers not to destroy our people.
Right.
Black brother, you must not distress your black sister.
Right.
Black man must not distress black people.
Right.
It is a sin against the Most High.
Right.
And there's a judgment and a punishment for destroying your own people.
Right.
Why, black man, you must destroy your people when every other nation is destroying us? Why, black man, you must do that? Why must you do that? Black man, why must you destroy your own people? Why must you continue to destroy your own? Why are we destroying ourselves? Black man, Hispanic man, Native Indian man, why must we continue to destroy our people? Why must we continue to oppress? Why must we continue to follow and look at what we are doing? We must continue to protect. We must continue to see. We must continue to love each other. This is what we must do as a people.
Right.
We must love each other.
Right.
Because these are the nations do not love us.
Right.
And they don't respect us.
Right.
They do not destroy us. This is why black on black crime will continue. But if they understand and they know that we must love our people, they will not rob and destroy your own people.
Right.
This is what we come out here to do, to teach the black man not to destroy his own people. To teach the black man not to distress your own people.
Right.
Because these are the nations do not love us. These are the nations who are going to destroy us and separate us. This is where love your brother as yourself comes in.
Right.
We have to continue to love each other. And this is why we learn this from the other nations. We learn how to rob and steal from these other nations. Because why? You know why a little black boy has to rob? Because he do not have the opportunities. How much East Indian you seen robbing? How much Chinese you seen robbing? How much white you seen robbing? They do not rob because they continue to rob us. And then we rob each other. That is why, because our minds are destroyed. Our minds are destroyed. When you see a black boy hold a gun to another black boy's head, why would you blame him? That black brother is oppressed. That black brother is hungry.
Right.
He will not rob the white man, because why? If he rob the white man will kill him. If he rob the East Indian will shoot him. If he rob the Arab will destroy him. But another black brother cannot defend himself.
Right.
Another black woman cannot defend herself.
Right.
So he will rob his black brother. He will rob his black sister. Because the laws that's supposed to be in the black man to love your brother and love your sister is not there. Because why? The Christian church teach that black man not to love his brother. The Christian church continue to destroy their people. When our Hispanic brothers and Hispanic sisters come here, they hate our Hispanic brothers.
What?
Why do they hate them so much? Because they are the children of Israel.
Right.
We must love our Hispanic brothers and sisters. They are also from the nation of Israel.
Right.
They come here because they are oppressed in their country.
That's right.
The same white so-called oppressor is across there. The so-called East Indian and Chinese is in Venezuela and all the South American countries oppressing our people.
Right.
They have to run from Venezuela to come here to get more oppression from all these other nations.
Right.
Why our Hispanic brothers and sisters have to go in whole houses to sell their bodies?
Right.
Why should they have to come and do that here? Our black brothers, our Hispanic brothers and sisters continue to be oppressed by these people. They continue. Why? Because our laws protect us. Our laws guide us. This Bible, these contain the laws that govern the black man, Hispanic man, and Native Indian man.
Right.
These laws are not done away with. These laws protect and guide and show us how we're supposed to love each other.
Right.
How we're supposed to live with each other. Go ahead.
Book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 17. Think not that I'm come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
He has not come to destroy. He has come to fulfill. Fulfilling is teaching your black brother not to hate another black brother.
Right.
Not to hate another black sister.
Right.
Because that could be a mother. That could be a friend. These are the nations do not love us.
Right.
We have to love each other first.
That's right.
That's it. Why rob your black sister? You will not get robbed. The East Indian man with the hardware. But you want to rob everybody else. Do not shoot your own black brother.
Right.
Do not do that. I am not advocating to go and rob other people. But you must love your people first.
Right.
You must love your black brother that you will not kill him.
That's
he
right.
is already oppressed.
Right.
He is already under pressure.
All right.
He already have nothing to eat.
Right.
They will rob him still. Why would you do that? Your brother is already on the ground.
Right.
Your brother already has nothing, but you will still rob him. Why? It's because these are the nations and the Christian church continue to destroy us. I cannot condone that black brother for doing that. But his mind is destroyed.
Right.
His mind is corrupted by this oppressed society. That he has no love for his people, but he will love the other nations.
Matthew chapter 5 verse 13. For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass.
Till what?
Till heaven and earth pass.
Till heaven and earth pass. Till heaven and earth pass. Go ahead.
One jot. Or one tittle.
One jot. One tittle.
Shall in no wise.
Shall in no wise.
Pass from the law.
Pass from the law.
Till all be fulfilled.
Till all be fulfilled. Till all the laws. Tell all the prophecies. Look the heaven here. Where the heaven gone? Look the earth here. Where the earth is. Till heaven and earth pass. Not one jot shall pass from this law. Word.
Verse 19. Whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments.
Whosoever shall break the least commandments. The heaven is here. The earth is here. Whosoever shall break the least of these commandments. What is the least commandments? The least commandments is what? Not stealing from your brother. Not stealing from your sister. A least commandment is not taking share-ups. A least commandment is not celebrating Christmas. Not celebrating Easter. One of these least commandments is loving your neighbor as yourself.
Right.
Your neighbor is not somebody living next to you. Your neighbor is your own people.
Right.
Your neighbor is your black brother.
Right.
Your neighbor is your Hispanic brother.
Right.
Your neighbor is your native Indian brother and sister.
Right.
Your neighbor is not the Chinese man.
Right.
Your neighbor is not the East Indian. Your neighbor is not the white man. Your neighbor is your own people. Your neighbor is your own people, black man. Love your black woman first.
Right.
Before you love any nation.
Right.
Love the Hispanic woman first. Before you love any other nation.
Right.
Love the native Indian woman first. Before you love any other. Love your black brother first. These other nations love their own people. But guess what? They make us forget the laws of God.
Right.
Because we forget the laws of God. We hate our brothers.
That's right.
And we hate our sisters.
Right.
That's why we rob each other. That's why we steal from each other.
Right. Whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments and shall teach men so.
Whosoever shall break and teach men to break the laws of God. Your Christian pastor is doing that every single day.
That's right. Right.
Teaching you to break the laws of God.
That's right.
Go ahead.
He shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven.
Your Christian pastor will be told he will be called the least in the kingdom. Because your Christian pastor telling you to celebrate Christmas.
Right.
Your Christian pastor is telling you to celebrate Valentine's Day.
Right.
Your Christian pastor is telling you to celebrate Eid.
Right.
Diwali and Easter. Your Christian pastor is a liar.
Right.
And a thief. Your Christian pastor conveniently telling you keep the laws of tithes. But he's telling you to forget everything else. Because
right.
he wants your money.
Right.
Your Christian pastor wants to rape and pillage your people.
Right.
The black community needs to separate and stick to the laws of God.
That's right.
Because the laws of God is made for you, black man.
Right. But whosoever shall do and teach them, the same shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven.
So black man, we are telling you to keep the laws of the Most High. To keep the laws. This is why we are here in Port of Spain. We can be anywhere else in this country, anywhere else in the world, but we are here for the black man. We are here for the Hispanic man.
Right.
We are here for the Native Indian man. Nobody else. Because the black man is suffering. The Hispanic man is suffering. The Native Indian man, like our sister here, is suffering.
Right.
Why should she be in this oppressed state? Why do we have to rob and steal from each other? Why should we have to go through all this?
The white man is the devil, our history is evidence. Coons say I'm racist, by definition I'm prejudiced. Got a right to be hesitant, as the African Methodists. We the endangered species, they'd rather protect the elephants. We the sons of God, like the seraphim. God chosen people from the Old and New Testament. Black power, Kwam Yasha Allah, black excellence. We your new rulers, bow down to your eminence.
They try to tell me I can't win, all because of the skin I'm in. But then I look in the mirror again, and then we realize we better than them, we better than them.
They try to make you think rich.
Why?
To make your whole life a big risk.
So what you do?
Commit a crime, get locked up, come home, can't get a job. Man, that shit just make you think bricks.
They trap you.
Ain't no way out of this poverty. Fuck being the prodigy, cause the world say you ain't shit. And then they give you religion. As soon as all that fails, they like to make you feel it ain't this, it's you. So what you do, you just can't get it right. Yeah, they like to say the truth hurts, but watch me take a life. And they like to keep you in darkness so you can't get the Christ. Not knowing like Jacob's sons, he is real light.
Get it?
So